Hello, my name's David Edwards, the film critic on the Daily Mirror. Today we're taking a look at Jason Statham's new film, The Mechanic.
What I do requires a certain mindset. I do assignments, designated targets. Some jobs need to look like accidents. Best jobs are the ones nobody ever knows you are there.
Jason Statham cements his status as the star of Big Dumb, Why the Hell Didn't We Just Rent This on DVD Movies, with an explosive but unimaginative remake of the old Charles Bronson flick, The Mechanic. Now, if you find yourself soused outside the multiplex late on a weekend night, this'll do very nicely. But if you're not in a state of advanced refreshment, you're in for an hour and a half of brain-crushing boredom.
There's no one better than you, you know. You're a damn machine.
The Stath, as he's now known, is Arthur Bishop, a professional assassin with a love of vintage sports cars and classical music, whose latest assignment is to off his mentor, played by Donals Sutherland, a hit that puts him on collision course with his new apprentice, played by Alpha Dog's Ben Foster.
Sorry about your father.
It was a loss for both of us.
I want to know what you know. Go online. It's all on the internet. But I don't want to read it. I want to do it. What am I? Know what a mechanic is?
A hitman.
If you've seen Statham's back catalogue, for example, The Transporter or Death Race, you'll know the drill. Slow motion explosions, copious gore, a smidgen of nudity, some homoerotic undertones, and, well, that's about it. Art it certainly isn't, but several cans of something strong should make this just about palatable, so we'll give it a 3.
Those were my best teams. Guess I'll have to send more.
Save the fuel. We're coming for you.